take a trip. Pass some water. Pass some trees.
Wait, don't you dare pass that.
Pinch yourself, because this is happening. And it might not ever happen again. Well, not like this. Because this kind of trip happens only in Minnesota.
Camp's just kind of that, it's kind of like Christmas, it's kind of like a birthday, you kind of look forward to it, and then once it kicks off, camp is camp, and it tends to be a grind at times, but you also realize that's the process.
Overall, as I look at practice, I see guys having fun, not getting to camp mode, laughing, talking a little trash, and just enjoying each other, and that's the biggest thing. Everyone enjoys each other.
Just keep it real out there, right?
Always.
Rodney Smith. Rodney, what's your favorite food?
Hot wings.
Rodney's favorite food, hot wings.
I feel like so far it's going pretty good. We got some good talent, some new guys out there. Got a lot of people who are ready to hit, get some paint on people.
This offseason, as far as from offseason starting in May all the way up to fall camp, and every day until it leads up to the first game of the season, I just want to work. More on my cuts, more on my offhand, being a better pass blocker, being a better run blocker, just giving Mitch that extra time or, helping him out in the run game, giving him that extra cut. And just for myself, just holding myself and being more consistent, just being accountable for all my mistakes and, just really learning the offense so yeah, I see it better on Saturday.
I told y'all I used to be a receiver, man.
When we go on the field, each guy knows in the back of their head that they want to be that guy, they want to be the starter. So, it's never any hard feelings or anything like that, and it never gets taken off the field. But on the field, we push each other. We push each other in everything we do, if it's sprinting, blocking, running, catching the ball. Everything. We have competition and consequences for everything. So if you drop the ball, it's push-ups.
I shouldn't even have to do these 10 push-ups. They know it was a bad pass.
If you come in a meeting when we joke about plays, things like that, and it's the same way on and off the field. None of us are too sensitive about it. If anything happens, we can always crack a joke about it, like, "Ooh, you were slow on that play," or something like that. And it won't get out of hand. I believe that's the kind of relationship we built as a core, and that's why I think we're successful.
You scared?
As a unit, running back wise, it's a really good stable. We've got some speed. We've got some power. We've got some guys that got a good mix of both. We've got some guys that can just finish plays, and that's a good thing to have. And, the biggest thing with that group is figuring out where all that fits. David Cobb, I think, has done a tremendous job in the summer, improving his explosiveness. Donnell, very smart, knows our offense well. Roderick Williams, he's kind of our banger. He's a big back. Berkeley Edwards, a guy who can flip the field for you quickly.
My goals for the year is really just to touch the field, because I feel like when I touch the field, I can make something happen. My strength as a running back is, I guess, my speed. That's the greatest asset I have.
I feel like running is going to be very important. We got to bring back, that ground pound. You're on goal line, whether it's 1 yard or 10 yards to go, we got to pound it in every time.
The run game is a priority for us, we're good at it. But we always try and strive for balance. And obviously when you have balance, your running game's that much better. in turn, a good running game makes for a good play action passing game. And now you got all your weapons that you want.
Yes. Here we go, sideline. Get out in sideline. Let's go. Hey, five step. A quick five on this. Quick five. Good. I told you to quick five. Fine, Max. Give him a catch. Let's go.
I feel really good about where the team's at this year so far through camp. I feel like we're a lot further along than we were last year at this time. And I know people who've been coming to our practices are definitely very excited about what they're seeing out there. And we just got to keep continuing to get better every day.
For them, the biggest improvement he's made is really taking what we do conceptually in the passing game and really just becoming an expert at that, trying to become an expert at that. That's his biggest growth of throwing block has come down to how hard he's worked and how much film he's watched to realize what should and should not be open. And he can make a throw and anticipate and make some plays that maybe he couldn't make before.
Great job. That's a great job. They're all bailing on stuff. The other thing, if you know you want to wave somebody, go ahead. Was that Venom? Yeah, if you want to wave somebody, you know what I'm saying? Like the Alistair, you know what I'm saying? Good job, boys. Good read.
Yeah, I think anyone would say just, you know, it builds confidence in a person when he knows that he's that guy and he knows he has a little more room for error and a little more room to, you know, learn the offense. And Mitch, I mean, since day one, coaches pointed him out to be the guy.
I think having a one quarterback system helps out everyone, just kind of getting the rhythm down and like just timing, knowing that every time you go out there, first huddle, it's going to be Mitch throwing you the ball. So you kind of build on that every day, knowing that, all right, we do captain's practice, Mitch is going to be throwing. We do practice, Mitch is there, getting that extra work. And just getting that system down where you get the chemistry of knowing you have that one quarterback system.
I've never seen a young man work as hard as he has, and I've had some good quarterbacks, and they've all worked hard. But I think sometimes you got to know you're the guy, certainly at that position. So I think that's helped him, and we've got some good quarterbacks in there, and they make each other better, and they're unselfish, which is important.
Last play of the game, five. You're done. Yes! 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 Oh my God. Play like a game, just like you did. Play like a game. Did you just give up on the post right away on the brown? Yeah. I don't want to out-coach the post part, but it's cover one, I'm thinking. If it's press cover one, I'm thinking, hey, I'm gonna see if he can win it. You know what I mean?
I think Mitch is the same person he's been since he got here, since the start of his career. He's always been that person that's intense, always the hardest working, always trying to be that leader. Now that he has that leadership tag with him, starting quarterback, being the only quarterback that's playing, really kind of emphasizes and shows that he was the leader the whole time and everyone's starting to realize it.
Every quarterback dreams of being the guy out there, and you know, I have my opportunity this year and I'm very excited for that. And you know, it was just a great opportunity for me with the receivers this summer to really get my chemistry down with them, to know the guys I'm gonna be with out there all the time. So it's very bright for me, and I'm very excited about it.
When you're a leader, you know, you can't be everybody's best friend. You got to do what's best for the team. And him and Cedric Thompson have done an outstanding job of leading our football team in the offseason. Now, if somebody's late, they take care of it. And so that's when you know you're turning a corner. And, you know, we came back, and we had our first team meeting. I said, this guy is our quarterback, he is our leader, and you will listen. We've never looked back since.